So it's breakfast time in Rio de Janeiro. The rain stopped. This is a very cute part, just down of our new Airbnb. So, we're still here at the park, very central. Nice graffiti there. 10 reais for the entire plate. Ah, so beautiful graffiti here. So, now let's check out the art museum, which is free on Tuesdays. So, this is the place.
After we had a lot of fun during our 10-day road trip, we returned our rental car back to Rio de Janeiro and decided to stay there for 1 week to explore the city.
Welcome to the favelas, made out of stone. That is really cool. I really like this art piece. It's a nice viewpoint, but the weather is still very bad.
So the first museum I visited was the museum called Arte do Rio. And as the name says, it's all about art from Rio. So you can see many paintings about the Pau de Açúcar, Christ, and also the colonial periods. It was very informative.
So Carioca is a word which means especially from Rio.
There were, for example, postcards 70 years ago from people, from tourists. And I guess they never got sent back home. And they wrote their experience in German and French. It was very interesting, at least. The museum also had some other floors which had temporary exhibitions about a modern art. And I really liked this huge spider in this room, which almost filled out the entire room, like in one of those horror movies with Godzilla. It's not my first time, as I came to Rio de Janeiro last year for Carnival in 2019. This time I want to have a different experience. So I decided to visit the museums of the city we haven't seen last time. Like any other big city, Rio has plenty of museums to offer. The good thing about Rio is that almost every museum has a free day on a certain day of the week.
So now it's time for the art museum. There seems to be a stage. This here is the art museum. Yeah, unfortunately the museum is under renovation, so it's closed. Delicious Bob's hamburgers. Ah, that's the famous train. In Lapa, the caipirinhas only cost $1.20 for half a liter. Here in Maracuya, how is yours?
You wanna say they have the seeds.
Oh yes, they have seeds. It's very tasty, very nice here. We really like Lapa because it is so cheap and so tasty.
Yeah, delicious.
So today we're in the art museum, which is free every Wednesday.
The next museum I visited was the Museum of Modern Art. Unfortunately, big parts of the museum were under renovation, so I think only half or maybe 60% were open to public at the time. Also, there weren't too many art pieces. It was a little scattered and smaller than the Museo Arte do Rio, which I had visited the day before. My favorite art piece was an interactive art piece where a staff member of the museum gives headphones to the visitors and there's a light circle on the floor and you just listen to relaxing music while walking in circles. That was just, yeah, really funny to observe and also interesting to do.
We have a beautiful lunch buffet for $3. Hola. I think this Flamengo Beach is one of the best urban beaches. Very close to the city center, it's in a like, nice park. really white sand, and there you can see the powder azúcar. My sweetheart is sick. Oh, they don't have ice cream, so sorry. Ah, the palms are so beautiful. This is the Brazilian Rio Cat Park. Lots of cats around here. We saw at least 15. They have little houses here at the parking lot.
Since Francisca really likes cats, she enjoyed the time playing with those stray cats there. They were actually not stray cats, I think they are having a home.
Yeah, so today we go to the museum. And there's also a very beautiful building next to it. Nice graffiti here at the museum. Brazil really has some of the best graffitis I've ever seen. I guess here is the entrance. Museu Histórico Nacional. Admission free on Sundays. Wow, this is a very big horse next to the elevator. Well, this once had been the largest museum in Brazil.
One of my favorite museums in Rio were the Museum of National History.
Impressive. This is from the Brazilian caveman.
We can learn a lot about the colonization period and even ways before that.
Very interesting art pieces. And then the Portuguese came.
Brazil was inhabited about 70 to 80,000 years before, and nobody knows exactly when people came.
Tiny people, huh? Church. Oh wow, they have a really cool garden here.
So as the first Homo sapiens came from Africa, it was a very long way for them to go to Brazil. So they had to develop clothes so they could pass the cold northern hemisphere to North America, and from there they went all the way down to South America. And I think it's very fascinating what Homo sapiens did. On the other hand, it's also sad how Homo sapiens destroyed so many species on Earth. They brought them to extinction. There was also a very interesting portrait of a former ruler from the Portuguese colonization time, and his face was scratched out with a sword because some people hated him. It still hangs like this nowadays, and it was really surprising to see it. So I highly recommend the book about brief history about Homo sapiens from the author. He's called Yuval Noah Harari.
Another beautiful day here in the restaurant, which is my favorite so far. Here's the shopping street in the city center.
Okay.
Carnival. Ooh, nice church. A fancy church here.
As Portugal was very Christian, they brought Christianity to Brazil and therefore built many churches. Unfortunately, most of those churches were built by slaves.
Money inside and a candle to light up for the good deeds. So here's where they make the sambacas. Whoa, very nice. Ah, here more sambacas.
I found out about the Ciudad de Samba through Airbnb experiences, as they offer guided tours.
A whale skeleton and a turtle. So here's the wax cabinet. I don't know who this lady is. Here's James Bond. Wow, wow, so cool graffiti here. It's really fun. fine graffiti. And it's got these huge lips.
So drinking night. It's so strange that this bar also sells like chloro, fish, sugar, toilet paper, and it's just, it's a bar, you know? They have food, it's very nice. And I'm watching soccer.
So here's the nightlife of Rio.
In fact, not only Rio, all Brazil has a very vibrant nightlife. You can have caipirinhas, cachaca, they have good beer, and Brazilians just love to drink. People already start drinking early. There are lots of bars on the streets. Beer is cheap and quite tasty. There are so many brands. One of the best brands is actually Eisenbahn from Blumenau, from the German immigrants. Yeah, but on this night, we hang out with people from couchsurfing. We went to a couchsurfing meetup and met many people from all over the world. Half of them were from Brazil and the other half were from Europe, Russia. We met Chileans, Argentinians, and we just had a great time. Unfortunately, I drank a bit too much and had a hangover the next day, but it was still fun. Hola. So this is our new Airbnb, really nice. I really like the view from the house. Oh, it's so bright. The camera can't adapt. Da. Here it is. This is the kitchen. And this is the view. Here, back to the viewpoint. My favorite viewpoint, the Mirador, Dona Marta. You can see the Jesus here on one side. And on the other side, you have, yeah, the Powder Açúcar, the city, and everything. So amazing here. Pizza on Valentine's Day, banana flavor,
cinnamon,
sausage, banana cinnamon, looks very nice.
Another beautiful church here in Flamengo.
Carnival already has started.
Hey! Foto, foto, foto!
It's a very nice neighborhood here. I like the graffiti.
Wow, way too many tourists here at this day. How can we take a photo?
The Escalera Celarón is a stairway in the center of Rio, actually in Lapa district.
If you can. You can see all the tiles.
It was created by the artist Jorge Celarón, as the name says.
Yeah, Snoop Dogg was here. Also these Chinese tourists.
Haven't been here last time, in fact. Huh? It's my first time here. Really? I missed this place last time. I forgot about it. It's very nice here with the tiles. 2010.
And it is very beautiful as the tiles depict the different countries, cultural things of Brazil.
Surprised that there's no police here, you know? Besides there's so many tourists.
And many of them were actually hand painted. So it's a big tourist attraction and it was really crowded.
And again, this wonderful church. This guy's not dressed properly for a church, but... Oh, so the church has a very own souvenir shop. Very interesting. Cool streets.
I have no idea where the flags come from.
But the houses look cool.
So back to Copacabana here. It's also Bloco. Feels already like carnival here.
So this is the hiking path to the Powder Asuka.
Instead of taking the very expensive gondola,
Atenção.
You can simply hike up the Powder Asuka. It only takes half an hour and I don't think the hike is exhausting. I really enjoyed the nature and you can even see monkeys there.
This is the first viewpoint. Looks pretty nice, also the beach. Oh, they apparently also have monkeys here. I mean, here's already one. Really cool here. And we made it this time by land. Seems not much demand for the helicopter due to the bad weather. We are done. So was it worth the hike?
I mean, of all the ideas that you ever have, it's one of the worst ones, actually. The clouds are so thick that you have to take a moment to see it.
Party catamaran.
So, she
just,
she come by food again?
No, she took the gondola.
Back?
Yes. We didn't see monkeys on the hike though, but they were actually right up the Powder Asuka. It's actually not the Powder Asuka, as there are two hills. And the bigger hill is the Powder Asuka, which you cannot hike up. And this is the smaller hill, which however offers the greater view. And I've been to the Powder Asuka last year, and I must say, the hike was much better than the gondola. Sunset time here and here.
So, since it's the end of the trail here.
So we don't go to the party, so the party called to us.
Yes.
Oh, we did it, you see that?